Chicagoland.
This scores a good guy hundred.
Otis LaVille sings Let Her Love Me.
This is the hit tonight. I close my eyes.
You know, VON is in a great city. It's a city that embraces its icons. And you think about legendary radio stations here in the city, WGN, world's greatest newspaper, and you've got a WLS, world's largest store, and then there's WVON, the voice of the Negro, around since April 1st, 1963.
You're among friends today, WVON's musical bouquet goes to...
Our bouquet today goes to Mrs. Josephine Johns Berryhill.
And it has built a great amount of credibility and trustworthiness in this community. It has chronicled this community's story from 1963 till today.
He was really saying something. That's a gas. I've done for you, Brother Velvet. Herbert Rogers came here with my most mellow Friday night cool on.
Oh, it was... First radio station totally dedicated to black people. There were black programs on other radio stations, WGES, WSBC, but they were sporadic, either some at night or some in the morning. There was no such thing as an all-together black station until WVON, and it went 24 hours, sun up to sundown. It just hit like a ton of bricks, and people loved it. Everybody loved it.
As I sit here meditating very deeply, a voice spake it unto me, saying,
WVON Cicero.
Half hour headlines. Headlines.
Your nearby certified food centers are presenting WVON's headline news, Roy Wood reporting.
WVON radio station, in its first wave of ownership through the Chess family, provided an outlet for black people to express themselves in their cultural milieu through a variety of music that was presented on the radio.
Jackson, Negro voting strength is expected to play an increased role in deciding today's Democratic primary election in the state of Mississippi.
Combined with a news format with the great Roy Woods, who was the newscaster of the stadium.
With us on our live line is a gentleman from the Electronic Intifada, Mr. Ali Abanima.
The hotline format that generated the interviews format and talk radio was probably the first of its kind in this country in the black community.
You think about what happened in the summer of last year, where you had these flash mobs and they got caught up in it. You know, they're young, they're stupid.
WVON has endured because it fulfills a need for information and communication. So it has lasted because it has institutionalized itself by the service that it renders.
Shields fired.
I'm still on there, people.
WVON, personally, for me, has been tremendous in terms of getting a voice out to a very strongly intelligent, very politically astute, and sort of common sense, world sense, international perspectives on local matters, to really sort of understand the dynamic and forecasting sort of where we are as a people.
And tonight on the Cool Gen program, it's Proviso East High School night.
I think the WVON has endured down through these years because of the way we started it, right? We did things that radio stations don't do today. We actually touched the people and became part of their lives. It was the thing that made us number one. I remember when we went on the air and got these tremendous ratings, these white stations had no idea who we were. And they called up, they said, "Who are you guys?" You know, a bunch of black folk like that, number one in the arbitrage. The jingle that really put us on the map, I'll never forget.
WVON
1450. It's just simple as that.
Have a great day, everybody, and we're going to do it all again tomorrow.
It's a great American story. You know, think about it. This station was started by Polish immigrants And then my father and his partner Wesley South bought the station after working for the Chess Brothers. And then I will go on to take the legacy over and lead it into its future.
1450, good company anywhere.
It's just a station that touches the people. It's a great, great radio station.
Universal News Shorts. WVON service for freedom.